Namaste and welcome to another episode of 103 FM's Diwali Khana. My name is Siddhi Sangha. I am a recipe developer for Chatak Food Products Limited. Today, I'll be sharing with you a simple curry recipe. Curry is made up of two parts, the gravy or the sauce, the actual curry, as well as the mochi or the pilori that is dipped inside of it. The pilori is a type of pakora. Pakora is a fritter and it is soaked inside of the curry gravy. So, we'll begin by preparing the pakora for inside of the curry. We start with 3 heaping tablespoons of chatak ground chana. To our chatak ground chana, we add a half teaspoon of chatak turmeric powder, or better known in Trinidad as saffron powder. This in India is called haldi powder. Next, we add 1/2 teaspoon chatak ground jeera. Now we add salt. Add just about 1/4 teaspoon of salt. Incorporate all the dry ingredients well. For another layer of flavor, we add chatak's curry masala, mild. Just about 1/2 teaspoon goes in to bring richness of color, flavor, and texture to the dish. Now we develop our flavors even more. 2 cloves of garlic, grated finely, and a bouquet of aromatic seasonings picked fresh from the garden. Shadobeni or culantro, fine thyme, and chives. Mix well to incorporate. At this point, if it is your desire to add vegetables, you can add grated carrots or pumpkin to make this dish a healthy option. Now that the seasonings are well coated in the ground chana, we add water. Water is used to bring the pakora batter together. You are looking for something similar to a thick pancake batter. If you think that you've added too much water, go ahead and add some more chana powder or chatak's ground chana. We leave this mixture to rest for about 15 to 20 minutes before frying. Resting this mixture allows it to develop flavor throughout, as well as it allows the chana to be fully cooked when done. Now we begin the curry gravy. The utensil of choice is a medium to large flat bottom aluminum pot, generously supplied to us by the Little Store Limited in Kirep. But before cooking, we'll start by preparing the curry. In our bowl, we have set aside 3 heaping tablespoons of chatak ground chana. Added to that, we have 3 heaping tablespoons of chatak split peas powder. Now, we add about 1 cup of water, stirring to form a thin batter. Set aside for 2 to 3 minutes. Now, in our flat bottom pot, we add 2 tablespoons of soybean cooking oil or coconut cooking oil and chatak's whole cumin or whole jeera, just about 1 teaspoon. These jeera seeds or cumin seeds will begin to sputter and fry very nicely to create an aromatic oil, tying this entire dish in from start to end. Next, we add 3 garlic cloves, thinly sliced, and allow that to fry nicely. This should sauté very quickly once the oil is hot. Be careful not to let it burn. Now we add 1/2 teaspoon of chatak turmeric powder and 1/2 teaspoon of chatak ground jeera. Our mixture that we had created with the ground chana and split peas powder, we now add very carefully into our hot oil. At this point, we want to begin to add some boiling hot water so as to achieve a smooth paste in the pot. Making curry is a slow cooking, long procedure. add more water and allow the curry to cook slowly while making figure 8 patterns with the dabla or wooden spatula. Lumpy curry is not desirable. For our pakora, we will use lotus soybean cooking oil. In a small pot, use enough oil to create a deep fry setting. If you have a deep fryer, you can feel free to use that as well. Remember to keep turning your curry. The perfect accompaniment to any curry dish is rice, and today we use lotus parboiled rice. Our soybean cooking oil is hot and ready to fry. In a very simple manner, spoon 1 tablespoon of butter into the hot oil to create dollops of pakora. Continue trying not to overcrowd the pan. Shape and size for pakoras don't really matter. It's all about the taste. Crunchy and perfect. As the pakoras fry, they'll float to the top. Remember to keep turning your curry. This particular combination requires a lot of multitasking. As your curry cooks, it should become thick and delicious. This pakora batter can be more smooth to give you more even pakoras, or even lumpier to serve the pakoras as an appetizer. Smaller pakoras can easily be used in curry, and your larger ones can be served simply with Chatak's tamarind chutney. At this point, our curry seems to be finished. So we're going to end this simply with some salt. Be shy with your salt, because you can always add more, but you can't take it out. Lastly, we're going to add a bouquet of herbs, chardobeni, local celery, and thyme. These herbs will bring forward the flavors of the pakora into the curry as well, not to mention make it look beautiful. Decorate your curry generously with your pakoras. And here we have it, curry and rice. A very complicated recipe, but yet very simple. Once those pakoras go into that gravy, they become soft and delectable. Rice and curry, simply by Chatak Food Products. Silky, smooth curry. A nice bite to the rice. It reminds me of a traditional Hindu wedding in Trinidad. And that brings us to the end of another 103 FM Diwali Khana. Thank you for joining us. See you soon.